Is your playoff push continuing to week 15? Is it possibly due to some of these studs? Here are my top boom plays from week 14. If I missed any that you had, leave it in the comments below. Tell me who got you to the next round. So here we go. The first one I'm going to talk about is the quarterback position. So we have Jalen Hurts, Tua Tagovailoa, and Mitchell Trubisky. You had Jalen Hurts was played in 2% of leagues this weekend. So if you were part of that 2%, congratulations, because he was very good this weekend. Those three outscored Patrick Mahomes, Kyler Murray, Josh Allen, and Justin Herbert. Those three combined outscored those four. So that tells you how the quarterback position went this weekend. So congratulations if you played any of those three guys, because it looks like they were the plays of the week at the quarterback position, along with Aaron Rodgers. Aaron Rodgers was a stud, but these guys weren't played nearly as much as Aaron Rodgers. The next one, Derrick Henry. I mean, absolute stud. He does this every single year. Every year for the fantasy playoffs, he goes on this run, and right now he's going on this run. Last week, it was obviously a little bit disappointing against the Browns, but this week, 215 yards, scored 35 plus fantasy points, was a beast. I'm sorry if you were going against him. It's very unfortunate, and I'm sorry if you have to play him next week against Detroit, because, well, Detroit's giving up the most fantasy points to the running back position this year. So not great if you're going against him. Great if you have him. He will probably be RB1 again this week. And the next one here is going to be Miles Sanders. I'm telling you this right now. If you didn't play him, you can't feel bad. This was not a good play at all. He hasn't done much this season. Last week against the Packers, he had 30 rushing yards. 30 rushing yards on 10 attempts. You had Boston Scott and Jordan Howard combined for 6 carries. How would you feel good about that? And then he's going against the league's best run defense. The defense that's giving up the fewest fantasy points to the running back position this year. It was not a good play. But if you were in desperation, kind of like myself in two of my leagues, I had to play him. I had no other choice. It worked out. It worked out for the best. He had 115 yards rushing and 2 touchdowns. Next week, he gets Arizona, so fire him up. He's going to be a good play next week. And congratulations if you played him this week. The next one is going to be Jonathan Taylor. Fantasy managers that maybe dropped him after the Tennessee game where he basically wasn't doing anything, don't look now, because the pass over the past 2 weeks, he's running back number one. He's running back number one right now. This is what people envisioned in the beginning of the season after Marlon Mack got hurt. They envisioned this Jonathan Taylor. Well, I'm telling you, next week it gets even easier as well, because he plays Houston next week. So fire him up. Does he stay atop the number one spot over the past couple of weeks? We'll see. But if you played him this week, I think he had 160 some yards, 2 touchdowns, absolute stud. Fire him up. Congratulations if you're still playing him. And congratulations if you traded for him, because he was the definition of a buy low candidate. And right now it's paying dividends. So congratulations. And the next one is Stefon Diggs. Congratulations if you drafted him this year, because he's possibly one of the biggest steals of the draft. Next year he's probably going to be, I'd imagine, maybe the first round, end of the first round, early second round. So congratulations if you drafted him. Crush the Steelers. They had no answer for him whatsoever in the second half. He did whatever he wanted. 10 catches, 130 yards, and a touchdown against that Pittsburgh's defense. So hopefully you started him. There was a lot of questions whether or not to start him against that defense. So hopefully you did. The next one here is going to be T.Y. Hilton. Through weeks 1 through 11, T.Y. Hilton was wide receiver 89 in fantasy football. Wide receiver 89. Since week 12 and on, he is now wide receiver number 3. Wide receiver number 3 in fantasy football right now. A massive turnaround. So if you started him, he was only started in 22% of leagues this weekend. If you started him, you're very happy. T.Y. Hilton right now is basically a must start. He plays Houston this week, who Houston can't cover anybody. They have Roby. He got suspended, so now they don't have anybody. They have Hargraves out there, who is giving up so much production. So fire him up. He's a very good start this weekend. The next one here is Travis Kelce. Travis Kelce, in my opinion, is the MVP of fantasy football. To basically be able to start Travis Kelce at the tight end position while everybody else is playing hot garbage is a massive upgrade, right? Massive upgrade. The dude is phenomenal. Like, he had 8 catches, 130 some yards, and a touchdown. There's nobody better at any other position. There's a massive gap right now at tight end with him compared to Darren Waller, the next one. A massive gap. Then there's a massive gap from Darren Waller to everybody else, right, to the next couple of guys. And then a massive gap. So he is just a huge advantage. So congratulations if you drafted him. I didn't in any of my leagues. Next year, I'll definitely consider it now. I don't like going tight end that early, but hey, He's the best at his position by a mile. And next week he gets New Orleans, who struggled against tight ends this year. So fire him up, bona fide start. Not like you're thinking about sitting him anyway. So amazing. Congratulations to you if you have him. And the next one here is Mike Gesicki. Mike Gesicki this weekend had 65 yards receiving, 2 touchdowns. The only blemish is he did get hurt at the end of the game. So if you started him, great job. But I don't know if he's going to play as of recording this right now. I know it was a shoulder injury. I don't know how serious it was. He was ruled out of the game. He looked in some obvious pain. So keep an eye on that. Hopefully he can go this weekend. Maybe next year we have some Patrick Mahomes and Travis Kelce light here with Tua and Gesicki. I'm saying light, right? Light. So next year, if you don't want to draft, say, Kelce, this is a guy that in the middle of the draft, later in the draft, I would look towards. It's Mike Gesicki. The next one here is going to be Washington's defense. Washington's defense scored the most points. You know, we thought the Rams were going to be the highest scoring defense after Thursday night. Washington said, hold my beer, and they went out there and they balled out. This defense right now is so good. Like, they're playing extremely well. Next week, they do get Seattle, but I will say this. If you're thinking about starting them, I think that they might be a good play, honestly, because you're going to have Seattle going cross coast to the East Coast, playing at 1 o'clock. Historically, those teams do not fare well when they have to do that. So, Washington at home against Seattle on the road, 1 o'clock, could be a good play, possibly. Maybe there's some other good plays that are on waivers or whatever. Look for the waiver wire video that I'll be posting. But very good play if you started them this week. They're played in 40% of leagues, so congratulations to you. And the last one here is going to be Greg DeLeg. Greg DeLeg came back to his old form instead of Greg DePeg. Somebody said that on YouTube chat the other day. Greg DePeg, great little nickname there. I don't know if somebody came up with it before him, but Greg DePeg. But Greg DeLeg, his old form came back. He was good this weekend. Really, kickers, there wasn't anybody scoring 20+. He was tied for second, but was only played in 20% of leagues. So 14 points this weekend. If you played him, congratulations. When kickers score 14 points, that's a very good day from your kicker. Very good help. So if you played him, great job. So with that being said, maybe I didn't get to some of the people you play. Leave in the comments below. Let me know who helped you win this week in fantasy football. And if you have any questions, leave in the comments below as well. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.